Dean's not an actor.
Wait, I have more things to say.
I warned Garth. I said, I'm not an actor. And he said, I'll always remember this, that he didn't want an act. He wanted the truth.
Listen up, ladies, we've got a situation. A little lass has just cracked her nut, and if she croaks, my ass is grass.
I said, this is going to be the most significant televisual event since Quantum Leap. I do not say that lightly.
I hope he heeds my words about being with this in an orthodox manner.
He will. He's the best damn doctor on the wing, or any other wing for that matter.
He's a wild card.
But I'm glad he's in our deck.
Let's hope he plays a fair hand.
He'll come up, trumps.
If it's not a joker in the pack. And sometimes there is.
I have no truck with snobbery. At all. To me, it's all the same. Literature, porno, dog racing.
You used this to treat him? Where the hell did you train?
I didn't want to use that thing. Larry was my friend.
If that's how you treat your friends, imagine how you treat your enemies. Worse, I expect. All right, calm down. Emotions are running high. What do you suggest, Dan?
Well, we can start by burning what's left of the body.
Get lost.
Cool it, Sanchez, or you'll get a knuckle supper. Look, Douglas, you're an excellent doctor, but you're also a live wire maverick, who, when he's not bucking the system, is biting the hand that feeds, which in your case, is this hand. Now, I'm not about to tell the immediate family of the deceased that we're going to have to burn what remains of his body in order to close the portals to another dimension. I just won't do it. This hospital's got a reputation, which I intend to keep. I've yet to see any demons on the ward, and I'm particularly observant. So go back to your lab and make me a pill that can cure madness, or I'll kick your ass so hard you'll be able to build a pool in the footprint. Understood?
As crystal. But if the gates of hell do reopen, don't say I didn't specifically warn you, because I just have, and that means you'd be lying.
I call Garth the Orson Welles of horror, and that's not just because of his weight. He is a titan of terror. I call him that as well. Garth has made a lot of people read. A lot. I mean, most people who read Garth's books hate reading. Garth makes people who hate reading read. And they won't read anything good, but they'll read Garth.
Telica what?
Put in punctuation. I see that as my job. Garth does one draft. He doesn't want to dull it by constantly revising. He'll do one draft and he'll often elect to omit punctuation. That's his call. I will put in commas. I won't put in semicolons. This isn't Joyce. I will omit dashes. Again, this isn't French writing. I will make sure that sentences start with capital letters, that's what they're called. I will make sure the book is long enough, or should I say thick enough. That could be a question of adding more words, it could be a question of making the paper thicker.
Thanks, buddy.
Rick, where are you going?
To get some air. To get away.
I've been criticised for only employing women at Devil Press, even for heavy lifting. Now, I work better surrounded by beautiful women. I think Garth, in terms of calibre of artist, will be remembered up with the very best. He'll be remembered in the same breath as Rick Astley.
That's a shame. I was looking forward to the chicken. Gentlemen and Liz, it seems as though we have a mystery attacker in Dark Place. I suggest we split up and search the hospital.
I, in consultation with Garth, will view the cover. Are there too many skeletons on this cover? Is this skull big enough? Could we fit more maggots on? Should bits of this book be pop-up? Questions like that. So it is creative.
Telica what?
I am self-taught. In fact, I've made it a point of honour never to learn anything from anyone else.
Uh-huh. Bye. Good gravy. A small bunch of objects are flying of their own accord in E-Wing. And apparently more objects are heading this way. Goodbye. Flying objects? It beggars belief.
You've had troubles at Dean's with underage girls.
Yes, I have, that's right. The main problem has been... I personally believe that really from 13 and up... Turn the other way. It's not a popular view, I know.
Telica what?
Society deems driving drunk unacceptable. That's a society we live in. So we have to accept those rules.
What do you think about it?
I am personally capable of controlling a car no matter what level of intoxication I'm up to. That's a gift I have. At the moment, the law denies me from exercising that gift. I personally believe that girls who lie about their age, and I'm talking about 14, 13-year-olds here, should be imprisoned. Or certainly sent to some kind of corrective institution. Because they're playing with fire. And if you play with fire, little girl, you're going to get burnt.
As long as it's not a screwdriver.
Yes, I'd prefer a beer. Dear me.
I've had a lot of trouble with censorship in my life. I don't believe in censorship. I don't believe in self-appointed judges. I don't believe in judges. I don't really believe in appointments.
Telica what?